I wanted to talk about all the problems with chronic inflammation, and there's quite a few. Let's start with the artery. Okay, the inside of the artery has this little lining of cells called the endothelial cells. And when you expose that layer of the inside of your artery to things that cause inflammation or oxidation or free radical damage, like sugar, having a high sugar level, or omega-6 oils especially, or other things like tobacco smoke or alcohol, whatever, you create irritation, you create chronic inflammation. And from that condition, you can get a clot because the proteins start to become sticky. You can then get a stroke or heart attack. And this also makes the artery thicker and more rigid, leading to high blood pressure. Also, the inflammation on the inside of the artery causes a healing effect where the body comes in with a Band-Aid with cholesterol, with calcium and scar tissue. Okay, so then you get an atherosclerotic plaque that can build up in the artery and also cause a heart attack. One really, really good thing to prevent and reverse this is get on the healthy ketogenic diet and do intermittent fasting, okay? And also take something called tocotrienols, which is a type of vitamin E that's very powerful to help heal and protect the inside of the artery from becoming damaged and inflamed. Also, omega-3 fatty acids like cod liver oil or fish oils are very, very important. Now let's go to asthma, which is a condition where your lungs are involved. There's inflammation. Vitamin D3 is the best antidote for that. This is why kids with asthma, if they're out in the sun, find great relief with breathing if they have asthma. Now, arthritis, there's two major types I want to talk about. Number one is the degenerative joint disease where you just have wear and tear in the joints. And the inflammation that can develop from that is just from irritation in the joints because you lost collagen, cartilage, connective tissue. One of the best remedies for that I found is stinging nettle root. And it seems to work really good for that condition. Shifting gears, an autoimmune condition. There's quite a few where your body is attacking itself, creating inflammation. This usually starts in the gut. There's also usually stress involved. I found personally there's a link between a major loss, which shocks the adrenal system and the immune system and allows this condition to progress. One of the best remedies for this would be getting on a low-carb diet, the healthy keto diet, and regular intermittent fasting, and a lot of vitamin D. For this condition, many times you need to do higher amounts of vitamin D, starting with like 30 or 40,000 IUs of vitamin D on a regular basis. And this seems to greatly improve this condition because vitamin D3 is one of the most powerful anti-inflammatories. All right, next point is stress that activates cortisol to the point where you either have a cortisol resistant situation where even though there's a lot of cortisol going through your body, which normally is anti-inflammatory, it doesn't work because the receptors are downgraded, so it's ineffective. Or it's a situation where you have a low amount of cortisol because the adrenals are burnt out, as in Addison's disease. In this situation, one of the best remedies is to support the adrenal directly, as well as take vitamin D3. Vitamin D3 is not really even a vitamin. It is a hormone and it acts like cortisol, but without the side effects. So cortisol really is an anti-inflammatory, but if it's not working, you get inflammation. Just think about any condition, any medical condition involving inflammation, whether it's just from having an autoimmune disease or some skin problem or a pain in your back, what do they use? Prednisone. What's prednisone? It's a synthetic version of cortisol. All right, so shifting gears, now we have diabetes, which is a state of high blood sugars, which creates a lot of inflammation in the body. And this is because high levels of sugar in the blood act like steel wool or sandpaper to the inside of the arteries, the inside of the kidneys, on the nerves, and the eyes, and it creates inflammation. What is the best antidote? Well, reducing the carbohydrates and reducing the sugar in the diet and doing intermittent fasting. All right, next point is just junk food in general, Okay, refined foods. What's lacking in refined foods is the antioxidants, okay, and the nutrients that act like antioxidants that then allow more oxidation and free radicals to create more damage in your DNA and the tissues. And so you just need to avoid refined foods and eat foods high in nutrients and naturally high in antioxidants. All right, next point would be infections. Let's say you had some bacterial infection, that you have a tooth infection that can create inflammation in different places in your body, even in your heart, which is actually quite fascinating, and in your joints. There are people that have arthritis that's all stemming from a tooth infection, okay? I've done a video on this and you can check it out. People that have chronic fatigue syndrome or fibromyalgia usually have some type of infection in their body. It could be either virus, like an Epstein-Barr virus, or it could be Lyme, or it can be some other virus that is going in remission and out of remission triggered by stress or age or whatever. The best remedy for this is to reduce your stress as much as possible and take things that are antimicrobial, like garlic, oregano, thyme, and herbs that actually can put these viruses back into remission. I've done videos on that. I'll put a link down below. Now let's talk about cancer, which is an interesting topic in relationship to inflammation. Cancer tends to follow inflammation. It tends to go into areas of your body that are inflamed. This is why cancer tends to show up in areas of old injury, which is very interesting. I've done a video on this. And so there's definitely associations between inflammation and cancer, increased risk of getting cancer with high levels of inflammation, probably because it's connected with higher levels of maybe viruses or carcinogens or damage in the body. Does inflammation directly cause cancer? We're not sure. It could, but we don't know yet. But we do know there are carcinogens, and there's also anti-cancer foods. There are certain things in foods, especially phytonutrients, for example, that have powerful anti-cancer effects that can help you prevent cancer. And then if you have cancer, it can actually help you kill cancer too. I've done videos on this. The other very important thing to do if you have cancer is fasting. Fasting probably has the most potent effect over cancer of anything, because when you fast, you turn on all sorts of anti-cancer genes, and you can even put a cancer gene that's active into an inactive state when you do fasting. And fasting directly has a potent effect over chronic inflammation. If you're new to my channel and you want more information about that, check out the video down below. Hey, before you go, real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself. And so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.